Now we are going to next lesson of Gulmohar book of class 4, and this lesson is third one. The name of the lesson is Tane and the Faraway Mountain. In Italy, in the Mesme hills of Arunachal Pradesh, young Tane Mina heard a wondrous call from the mountains in the distant. She was drawn to it, a sound only she could hear. Children, in Italy, in the hills of Arunachal Pradesh, there was a small girl whose name was Tane Mina. She used to heard a strange call, strange sound from the mountains, which she can see only from distance. She was drawn to it. Means those hills and that sound, they used to attract her. A sound only she could hear. This sound is only heard by her. No one else can hear it. No one else can feel it. She heard it while she climbed trees. She heard it when she ran through the jungle. She heard it when she spent long days lying under the sun. Whooshu, the sound went. Whooshu. Whenever she used to go under the trees and used to climb on them, she used to go in jungle. And whenever she is lying in the sun, she used to hear this strange sound, and this sound tempted her very much. This sound of whooshu disturbs her a lot. It used to attract her a lot. Ah, Tane would smile. What a wonderful life. But one day her family moved out of Cali to the closest big town Roing. Tiny's world turned upside down. One day something happened like that. Her life was wonderful, but suddenly her family moved away from Italy to a nearby town, and the name of the town was Roing. Now the whole world of Tane would turned upside down, means it changed totally. Upside down means changed totally. There was a school in Roing, but the whooshu had been louder in Italy. Even though in Roing also there was a school, but instead of that school, she was more attracted by that old whooshu sound that was a call from the mountains. Means the mountains still attracted her very much. Tane wanted to return to her mountains again. It clearly shows that she wanted to return towards the mountains. So she trudged to school every day for 10 years, glancing wistfully at the mountains in the horizon. When she finally finished her schooling, Tane immediately applied to be a porter for army expeditions in the mountains. She would have to carry heavy loads and march over long distances. Now children, though she was not willing to do the schooling over there, she wanted to go back towards the mountains, but still she has to do that. So she continued her schooling for 10 years, and after completing it, she immediately at once applied for the post of the porter. And she was supposed to carry heavy loads over the mountains for the long distances. But women were not allowed to be porters in those days. Actually, those days, women were not fit. They were not supposed fit for the jobs of the porter. Children, what is the porter? Porter is the person who used to carry the loads, right? Here, she wanted to carry the loads for the long distances on the mountains. Tane did not let that stop her. She dressed as a boy and started to work. Means that she decided that she will do that job. So she hid herself being a girl and dressed himself as a boy, make herself look like a boy, and joined the work. And nearly 1 week passed. Nobody can recognize her. And she carried 25 kilos of luggage every day for the mountains. After 1 week, then everybody realized that she was not a boy, she was actually a girl. The officers scolded Tiny for breaking the rules, but they knew that Tiny knew the route better than anyone else. So they allowed her to continue working. Her act would later help lift the ban on female porters. Now children, when the officers came to know that she has broken the laws, then they scolded her. But they knew that she was the one who knew the road very nicely, who knew all the routes and tracks of the mountains very perfectly. So they allowed her to continue the job. And you know children, this is the effort of Tiny that the ban, the prohibition on the female's entry in the porters, in the field of porter's job, was totally removed, and now females are also allowed for the job. In the army, Tiny worked on many expeditions and soon became a coordinator. It was on one of her expeditions as a coordinator that she met Dr. Romeo Mattei at that time. Dr. Mattei was working to promote adventurous sports in Arunachal Pradesh and immediately identified Tiny's talent. "You are a naturally gifted climber," he told her. "You have the strength and the determination. Now all you need is technique." Now children, it was divided into four sections so that the climbers could take rest at different camping points while journeying to the top of the mountain. By the time Tiny and her companion, Sharing Sherpa, reached the second camp, the weather had grown worse. Children, when they started their journey, their expedition towards the Mount Everest, their journey was divided into four parts, four sections. And these four sections are made to give the rest to the climbers. Each and every section, they are supposed to take the rest. When they started their journey towards the top of the mountain, you know, when they reach on the second camp, the weather was very, very bad. It was very bad. "Do you want to go ahead?" Sharing asked. Tiny's companion Sharing asked her, "Do you want to go ahead?" Either she want to left it. "I don't think I'll get another chance to do this," Tiny replied. She could hear the musical wushu growing louder and louder. Tiny said that, "No, I am not going to leave it. I am not going to quit from this because I don't think that I will get another chance for this expedition." And this great sound of wushu, it was going louder and louder, means the temptation of the mountain was growing more and more. It almost hypnotized her. Tiny and Sharing somehow managed to reach their final camp. Just as they were about to take rest, the stormy wind blew their tent and supplies away. Children, this magical sound of wushu, it put him in the magic shell. It hypnotized her. She was lost in the magic of the call of mountain. Children, somehow they managed to reach. Children, she was fond of mountains, but she don't know till this time which is the farthest, yeah, either highest mountain of the world, of that place. But now, when she watched the movie The Race for Everest, this is the film which was made on the first climb of Mount Everest. It was a film. So when she watched this film, then she make it her dream to reach on Mount Everest. And now the call from the mountains, the attraction, the wushu sound that stands for the attraction of the mountain, became more and more louder. After months of preparations, Tiny finally reached the Everest base camp in Nepal. It was bitterly cold and air was thin. Tiny trained there for a few days to get accustomed to the harsh weather and then began her climb. Now, children, after months of preparation, after months of training under Dr. Mattei, she finally reached towards the base camp in Nepal. And this was the base camp of Mount Everest. Here the special training for the persons used to give who want to climb on the Everest. It was bitterly cold and the air was thin. When she reached over there, the air was very thin and it was cold also. Too much cold was there. So she got trained, she got herself used to for the harsh weather, for the coldest weather. The climb was difficult. Then she started to climb on the mountain, Mount Everest, and the climb, it was very difficult. It was not an easy task. It was divided into four sections so that the climbers could take rest at different camping points while journeying to the top of the mountains. But by the time Chinne and her companion, somehow they managed to reach to their final camp. But just as they reach over there, the storm began more and more harder. It became more worst. And it has taken away all their supplies and their tent also. All the things have blown in that storm. They had to spend the night in one borrowed tent, and when they set off for the final climb the next day, all Chinne and Sharing had was a packet of noodles. Now everything was gone. So when they supposed to start next day, what they were having to eat? Only a packet of noodles, nothing else. Let's share half of it, Sharing suggested. Sharing said, let's use half packet and we will share that half now. Means in half packet they both are going to feed themselves. Chinne nodded her head, smiling determinedly. If we make it alive, we'll eat the other half. Chinne also agreed to that and determinedly, very firmly said to him that okay, we will share it half and half part we will eat if we will remain alive later on. The higher they climbed, the stronger the wind grew. For every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. Just as they were growing higher and higher, the height was increasing, the wind was also being stronger. And when they took two steps ahead, it set them one step behind. It shrieked and howled, whispering dread into their ears and urging them to return. But Chinne could only hear the musical tune of Wushu, so they pushed ahead fearlessly and continued to climb up to the top. Children, it was very difficult. Now it is growing more and more difficult for them to move upside because the wind is more and more stronger. With each and every step, every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. Just as they were growing higher and higher, the height was increasing, the wind was also being stronger. And when they took two steps ahead, it set them one step behind. It shrieked and howled, whispering dread into their ears and urging them to return. But Chinne could only hear the musical tune of Wushu, so they pushed ahead fearlessly and continued to climb up to the top. Children, it was very difficult. Now it is growing more and more difficult for them to move upside because the wind is more and more stronger. With each and every step, it was growing and it was becoming more worst. But the sound of that Wushu, that attraction was growing even harder than that. So they moved ahead. They continued their journey very nicely. Finally, at 10:45 a.m. on 9 May 2011, Chinne's effort was rewarded. She summited the Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world, the first woman from the northeast of India to have done so. She had found her faraway mountain and was one with the sound that had called her all her life. Now, children, after so much difficulties, on 9th May 2011, at the time of 10:45 in the morning, she reached on the top of the mountain. Her efforts were rewarded. He got the prize of her efforts. She summited means she
overcome, she got the victory over Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world, and she became the first woman of Northeast India to do so. And now she reached over the mountain and also get the dream of her life fulfilled. I hope, children, you understand this lesson very nicely. Who need is technique. Now, children, in the army, Tiny works for many expeditions, and soon she became a coordinator because of her experiences. During one expedition, during his one travel towards the mountain as a coordinator, she met with Dr. Romeo Mathai. Who was Dr. Romeo Mathai? He was a promoter. He was a promoter of adventurous sports in Arunachal Pradesh. And he immediately recognized the talent of this girl, Tiny. And he said that, dear, you are having a God gift. You are having the ability to climb on the mountains. You are having the perfection in doing that. You are having the strength. You are having the firm determination. Only one thing you are lacking, you don't know, that is technique. And if you get the training, you can get it and you can go forward in that. Dr. Mathai became Tiny's mentor and she began her training as a mountain climber. The distant mountains still called her. Now, Dr. Mathai became her mentor. Mentor means guide. Okay? See, he guided her and now began her training as a mountain climber. Now, the call from the mountains is louder. Children, now the attraction towards the mountains is becoming more and more greater. But Tiny did not know the name of the distant mountain till she watched the Race for Everest, a film about the first climb of Mount Everest. Wushu became a roar now and climbing Mount Everest became her dream. Children, she was fond of mountains, but she don't know till this time which is the farthest, either highest mountain of the world, of that place.